Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ravinia Festival. Please note that the taking of photographs, including the use of camera phones and the use of audio or video equipment, is strictly prohibited. As a courtesy to the artist and your fellow patrons, please ensure that all mobile phones, pagers, and anything with an on-off switch have been silenced. We appreciate your consideration. Thank you for making it a great day at Ravinia.
Good evening. My name is Alejandra Valarino Boyer. I am the new director for the Ravinia Staines Music Institute. Thank you. And I'm just so delighted to get to welcome all of you here. You are the first large audience that Ravinia Staines Music Institute has seen in Bennett Gordon Hall since the summer of 2019. So thank you. Yeah. Tonight we're going to hear winning compositions from some really talented composers as part of the Bridges Composition Competition. These composers created new 10-minute works that bridge jazz and classical genres and were selected from a national pool of applicants. We're going to hear our 2020 winners in the first half and then listen to the premieres of our 2022 awardees. This evening we also have the great pleasure to celebrate with the Ravinia's Women's Board, many of whom are in the audience this evening. The Women's Board is celebrating its 60th anniversary today, and they have been steadfast supporters of the Ravinia Staines Music Institute, and they are the reason why we're here today. 12 years ago, they provided the funding for our program for jazz, and so we're incredibly grateful to them and wish them so much happiness and joy in their 60th year. Thank you. So this program really could not be possible without our amazing jazz program directors, and I am so honored that I have the privilege to introduce the one and only Rufus Reid.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming, because tonight is special. First of all, you're here. And this is my 22nd year with the jazz here at the Staines. And it has indeed, each and every year, people come up to me and say, is jazz dead? And literally, they ask that silly question. But you'll know the answer after you hear these people. And then those of you who are here, you can come back next Friday and hear the new crop of musicians that came in yesterday. But tonight is really special because you get to hear six pieces, three from last year and three for this year. And we had 26 applicants this year to choose from, and I couldn't do it alone. And the people who have helped me, and we help each other actually become kind of the coaches for some of these players, and then we get a chance to listen to these magnificent compositions, and I just want to introduce you to Billy Childs, who's one of our faculty members, and he's a composer, Billy Childs. Now you see him, okay. And Mr. Steve Wilson. It's very exciting. Between the three of us, we have years of experience. And so it's really been a real pleasure. We all get inspired, and we hope you will too. And so we're going to introduce to you the gentleman who wrote the piece that ended the concert last year. Please welcome Mr. Steve Feifke.
Wow. Hello, everybody. How are you? Cool. When I first found out about this program existing, I said to myself, are you kidding me? Like, there's a chance to literally work with Rufus Reid, Billy Childs, and Steve Wilson in the same place at the same time, in the same week, with an incredible ensemble that you can literally hear and workshop your music for an entire week. I literally said, no, that's not real. That's crazy. And well, it was real. It is real. Being here is an absolute honor. And it's been such a special week. It's been such an incredible experience to come back here. Hey, just notice the balcony up there. You'd think my mom was up there or something. She's not, but anyway, it really is it's a very unique and special program that's being run here. And before we start, I just want to say huge thank you to Rufus, Steve, and Billy for having me and for just doing all of this. You guys really are legends, and it's an honor. Enough said. I also want to say a special thank you to Alejandra and to Ariel and the whole team, the staff, the sound guys, the sound people, and everybody who's an intern this week for making this run smoothly. And of course, to this ridiculously talented ensemble, the Avalon String Quartet, and a bunch of my friends from New York, Glenn, Dan, Ken, and Greg, and it's really a treat. So I'm talking too long, for sure. But I guess I just want to communicate how much of a gift it is to be here, and we hope you enjoy this concert. Thank you all so much.
Thank you. Wow, what a way to start off a program. I've got goosebumps. Our next composer, Addison Frei, was unable to be with us in person. His talents as a great pianist was in demand in Nashville tonight. Apparently making too much money to be here, but but we wish him well. And this is his composition, Comment on War, which draws on inspiration from Langston Hughes's eponymous poem. Rather than depicting explicit battle, the piece reflects on Hughes's interrogation of the truths that war makers manufacture to manipulate their forces, irrespective of the immense human costs. This is Comment on War from Addison Frei.
Thank you. Said Billy Childs, Rufus, Reid, Steve Wilson, they've been idols of mine for a while. I've always loved their compositions, their music. So to get the opportunity and the honor to work with them was really tremendous. So thankful to them. Thank you for your mentorship. And thank you to all the Ravinia staff, to Alejandra, Ariel, Hannah, for all your help during this time, and to this tremendous band. So without further ado, I'm excited to present my piece, Insomnolence, to you all. It's going to feature Glenn Zaleski on piano, Greg Ward on soprano sax, and Kenneth Salters on the drums. Thank you.
Thank you.
How about that first half, huh? And what we're going to do now is present the awards to this year's composers who won the commissions. So put your hands together for Gary Wang. Turn around and says, okay. Our next composers, Jisu Jung. Our third and last composer, William Kjeer. So we'll invite the musicians back on stage, and Gary's going to tell you a little bit about his piece.
Oh, hi, my name is Gary Wang, and I originally from Beijing, China. So it's really an honor I can bring my music to the stage and work with these great musicians, and also just have been here a week working with Billy, working with Rufus, working with Steve, and hearing all the great composers is like super inspiring, and it has been like a dream for me. And so talking about a little bit of my piece, so I grew up listening to some classical music, so I got to fall in love with Schumann, Brahms, and Chopin's music a lot. And when I started to explore more jazz vocabulary, I found there are lots of similarity between Bill Evans playing, Fred Hirsch playing, and with those classical musicians. So when I try to write this piece, I try to put all those knowledge I know, mix them together, and create the music for this ensemble. So I think there is a program switch between me and Jisu. So on the program, I'm the fifth one, but I'm actually the fourth one. And my piece is called Lullabye and Dreams. It features the great pianist, Glenn Zaleski, and also Greg Ward on saxophone. Hope you guys enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Are you enjoying the concert tonight? Thank you so much for being here with us. It's really, really means a lot for me and maybe for all the composers here. I definitely want to say thank you for Three Mentors for your support, like sincerely. And then I want to say thank you for all the performers here, because they have been like rehearsing for 6 hours a day, every day. So please make a clap for them. Since I have a strong background for both jazz and classical music, all the process for preparing for this competition means a lot to me, and me being here is really special. Since I'm so nervous, I'm just gonna read the note what I wrote. In the spring of 2021, I began to think about how during the COVID era, many people, including myself, were yearning for freedom. I wanted to express this desire through music, which is how Momento Journey was born. I wanted to take listeners or you guys on a journey away from the restrictive COVID era reality by providing a momentary release, a space relieved from limitations. Hope you guys enjoy. Thank you so much.
Well, how about it? What a night. This week, I knew it was going to go by fast, and it went by so fast that I don't know what happened, really. Here we are on the last tune, and it feels like Sunday was yesterday. And it's also a night of gratitude, so, you know, it's been said several times already with good reason, but I want to just say thank you one more time to the mentors and my fellow composers and everyone behind the scenes who made this possible this week. This is a really one-of-a-kind program. You will not find anything like this almost anywhere else. So this is very, very cool. I still can't really believe I'm here. One more time, I'd like to thank these wonderful players, starting with the Avalon String Quartet. On the drums, Kenneth Saunders. Salters. Salters with a T, my apologies. On the bass, Dan Chmielewski. Should have worked on my pronunciation beforehand. This is great for me because usually I have to perform when I'm up on stage, and this is crazy to have the great, great Glenn Zaleski playing all the pieces tonight. And I wrote mine for Septet, but please one more hand for all the amazing solos you've heard tonight from Greg Ward. And I'm also just gonna read what I wrote about my piece. For those of you who don't have a program in front of you. So Reconciliation is the name of my piece, and I find this kind of music very reflective. And so this was written during my time in quarantine with COVID-19, and the name was inspired by the nature of our shared experience during these last 2 years, and also by our unique personal journeys, the things that have happened to us as individuals, and how we've coped with them amidst the broader storm. I hope that everyone here can find something to relate to and reflect upon as the arc of reconciliation unfolds. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Give it up for the ensemble. Give it up for the ensemble. Yes, indeed. Take a bow. Looks like all the composers up here. Yes. Yes. Ah. Ow, there it is. Okay. Now look at you. Look at you. You're standing up and you didn't really want to leave. Give it up again. Huh? So the future of this music is in very good hands. And the marriage of the bridges, bridging the classical music with the jazz, it actually works. And it's fresh, and we need you, but because you're standing up, that meant that whatever you heard, it got to you. And the music is very powerful, and these people worked really hard. I mean, the composers, you know, composers are in a vacuum by themselves, you know, for long periods of time to get the inspiration to come up with. And I'm still intrigued by it in terms of the way that these young musicians actually can come up with this, and these musicians being able to take it off the page and bring it to life. That's what it's all about. Thank you. So you need to tell the people who are responsible for this that you enjoyed yourselves, and you'll be back next week for some more stuff. Thank you so much.